What's up, guys? It's me, Deshaun. We're back at it again with another My Hero video. Before we start the My Hero video, I just want to say, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. But not only that, please check out our Patreon if you want more content, you want to support us. Check it out, you know, give us some bread or whatever, so we can up the quality of our videos. But not only this,
make them come out even faster. But enough of that YouTube bullshit, let's jump into this My Hero video. It's time we talk about the old My Hero. And no, we're not talking about the My Hero one-shot. We're talking about the unofficial, well, you know, somewhat official, artwork that Horikoshi has drawn on his Pixiv account, which has been taken down, I might add. So I just want to get this out of the way before we officially start looking at this artwork, because this is going to lead into a topic that I'm actually going to save for another video, because it's obviously going to be bigger, and that topic would be the actual identity of My Hero. Because it's come to my attention that a lot of people don't understand Horikoshi's style, but not only this, they don't understand My Hero as a series. And that can also be a reason as to why people don't really find this series appealing, because they like to jump to the assumption and say it's a generic shonen, rather than letting this series pace itself and build up to something grand. Again, I'm going to go over that more in another video, because this video I solely want to focus on the old My Hero in general. Because through this artwork, not only can you develop a lot of visual storytelling, well, you know, you're supposed to develop visual storytelling because it's a fucking manga, or, you know, in other words, a piece of art.
Just in case if you don't know what that is, it's when you look at a picture and it tells a story. To really simplify this, let's use the Mona Lisa as an example.
Yo, why the fuck is she smiling?
I bet it's because she's thinking about what she's about to eat later.
Okay, now let's do this, but without the art is subjective argument and without the headcanon. Now, when we look at this first drawing, I think it would be safe to infer that these kids would be students. But not only this, this is a lot more of an edgier take on My Hero Academia. Or so it would seem. Because what I want you guys to realize is, by the end of this video, I want your perception of My Hero Academia to change. Because I would argue that the series is on the exact same energy in this photo. And I'd like for more people to realize that, because I've seen a lot of comments saying that they would prefer, or they would think My Hero would be a lot more interesting if it was like the earlier depiction of it in this artwork. And again, I want you guys to realize that nothing has changed, because a lot of the themes in these images are still alive in My Hero. It's just that these themes have not taken the forefront of the story yet. And that's obviously because the story needs to build up to this stuff. Or it wouldn't be as satisfying if Horikoshi were to not progressively build up to this. Because at that point, if the story would have started off with this morbid atmosphere, you would have felt like that you've seen everything there is to see in terms of My Hero. But with Horikoshi keeping a lighthearted mask over top of it, not only does it give the series another unique identity, but this also allows the series to have more lighthearted moments, and the most important thing is the fact that this lighthearted aspect in the series, this lighthearted mask on the series, fits perfectly with the themes that the story is trying to tackle. Hero society is a sham. Making people believe everything's puppies and rainbows, is that any better than brainwashing? And that is basically what the lighthearted nature of this series is. What they want you to think Hero Society is. And what Horikoshi wants you to think My Hero Academia is. This artwork right here shows you the truth of what My Hero is. And there are many moments in the series, many things in the series, where this darker tone from this artwork and other pieces that Horikoshi made like it actually bleeds through in My Hero. For example, when we look at Midoriya's new look, he definitely looks like he'd belong in this artwork rather than the lighthearted My Hero that we all know and love. But not only this, the more morbid moments such as Shigaraki's backstory and the fact that Nomus are actually humans, all of these darker themes are exactly what's under the surface of My Hero. and my hero hasn't changed one bit. And if this isn't an example of masterful storytelling, I don't know what the fuck is, bro. Now, before we go on to the next image, I just want to point out one last thing about this one. I could just really see these darker themed hero characters just murking the absolute dog shit out of the CRC. I don't know why that comes to mind, but that's just really cool to me, bro. I just had to share that. Now, on to the next image. Now, quick question. Would y'all kiss her on some Princess and the Frog energy? But, you know, I guess you could say weaving mutated dog waifu energy. Okay, but outside of that, this photo really does encompass one of the main conflicts caused by quirks.
I like to call them cursed quirks.
Because basically you get a shitty quirk and you're kind of cursed because it's going to mess you up for the rest of your life. And we see a clear-cut example of this when All For One is taking away this man's quirk so he can recruit him to his army. Are we potentially going to see more of this? Maybe rather than being a background character in a flashback, we could get a more developed character with this same issue later on in the series. But again, just like this artwork, this problem, this conflict still persists in the actual manga. And this really stresses the horror in quirks. And another horrific aspect about quirks is the fact that humans aren't the only ones affected by them. After all, we have Principal Nezu, Gang Orca, and others like them throughout the entire series. Basically, they're animals that are a lot more humanoid because of their quirks. But what about the actual wildlife in My Hero Academia? I feel like this is a really grotesque and disturbing aspect in the story that still has yet to get tackled. What if the students were to go to a zoo and they were to see animals that look like this? Not even just that, but what if the heroes actually encountered a chimera and had to fight them? I feel like the wildlife and the concept of animals as a whole is a very interesting aspect to touch on in My Hero Academia because we have yet to see either of them. Well, of course, outside of animal people. Not only could you add some very good horror elements with these grotesque looking animals, similar to how Mike showed up in Hunter x Hunter, or you could literally take this grotesque animal aspect and kind of show the beauty in it. And through this, you could make a very sentimental scene. These animals may look disgusting, but this is the nature that they know in My Hero. I could only imagine just how tear-jerking it would be if one of these whale tigers had a baby. And despite how nasty that may look, you could still see the beauty of nature within that scene. And the same could be said about this image of this girl with her horn quirk. Or I guess you could say sheep quirk, because at least to me, it looks like her hair looks like sheep fur. And she also has the horns of a sheep. And that would say a lot because sheeps are actually known for being defenseless. And you could take this character with this sheep quirk who would most likely want to be a hero, but how could someone so weak or frail and delicate, because you know she's also a female.
Don't take that the wrong way, please.
But yeah, sheeps are known for being weak and defenseless, and females are kind of viewed that way as well. But through this artwork and through this series, your expectations would be subverted because this girl is capable of becoming a hero who can not only defend herself, but also defend those around her with her own newfound strength. Despite how horrific or monstrous her horns may look, and despite how frail she may seem as a sheep and also as a woman, your expectations will be subverted because you do not know her story. Despite how this girl is a sheep mutant, there is also some beauty behind all of this grotesqueness. And the same could be said for this photo of this young lady that Horikoshi drew with tree branches growing out of her fucking head. You could view it as horrific and disgusting that these tree branches are growing out of her head, but when you think about it, there's actually a subtle beauty to it. With one of the narrative themes in My Hero being we live in a society, the industrialization of society has been causing humans to become more out of touch with nature. And this is a real-world problem that is tackled within the series. And believe it or not, living in harmony with nature is actually a big part of Japanese culture as well. And I do not find it surprising that Horikoshi vents that in this current piece, and we actually see an example of this in My Hero Academia with one of the users of One For All. Hikage Shinomori, the user of Danger Sense, was a weirdo who shunned modern society for the life of a hermit. And to that he responds, "Mine was a terrible era, they were the weirdos, not me." And this would actually make a lot of sense because of all the technological advancements and the further industrialization of society would yet again make humans lose or become more out of touch with nature. But just like in this current artwork that's up on the screen, and just like in the manga, quirks actually help people to become more in touch with nature. Hence Shinomori training in the forest, and hence this girl in this photo actually becoming more in touch with nature because she has branches growing out of her fucking head. And now for the last example of the beauty in quirks, or the more solemn themes that take place in My Hero that could potentially have more depth later on in the series. Quirks have the potential to add a lot more surrealism into this series, as seen with the past few art pieces that we just covered. These fever dream-esque, unorthodox drawings that Horikoshi made are just very small examples of the unlimited potential this series has and what's to come from the future of it. Despite how bizarre and weird these drawings are, despite how unorthodox they are, these drawings will ultimately make you feel something and feed your creativity just like this manga. Why the fuck is an eggplant flying? And why is Uraraka standing on that eggplant? Who knows? Who cares? But this is very emotional. If you gave a scene like this context, not only would it be an amazing work of art, but that should just really show you how open-ended quirks can make this manga, and just how flexible Horikoshi's creativity is. Not only can we get some great horror elements out of the story, but we can actually get something that is thought-provoking as well. Now this video has been long enough already, so I want to wrap this up really soon. I know there are still other images that I have to cover, but I think I proved my point enough with this video. I hope by this point in the video that you guys have gotten even more invested into My Hero, and hopefully that your perception of it has changed as well. It's about time we all stop sleeping on this masterpiece.
Or who knows, maybe I'm just a crazy guy on the internet who doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about and My Hero is just another generic shonen.
I'll see you guys in the next video!